It is a derby today, and there may be 4,000 miles in between them, but it is an intense rivalry that stems back to when Australia joined the Asian Football Conference. A derby day for this World Cup qualifying game, and I'm your host, Andrew Sell. Australia are looking to make it 4 from 4 today at the head of the Group B table, whilst Japan, with 1 win and 2 defeats, need to get something from this pivotal fixture. Australia's hope of maximum points is under threat today, as they've never actually won on Japanese soil. But a point might just be acceptable for Graham Arnold's side. The weather today just under 21 degrees, but it's a chance here. The confidence, though, will be high for Graham Arnold's side, as they are on a current unbeaten run of 11 games. For Haji Moriyasu's side's defeats to Oman and Saudi Arabia have made qualification a lot harder. This game appears far more important to them than their visitors today, Australia. Australia are the group favourites to qualify for Qatar 2022, and they are in fine form, but Graham Arnold's side, well, they've got to try and win for the very first time on Japanese soil. The Japanese side today shows a few changes, and they've brought in real quality as well. The captain there, Maya Yoshida, is making what I can only tell you is his 111th appearance. Retirement may be beckoning for him round the corner, but he'll certainly be giving it everything to get Japan's World Cup qualifying campaign back on track. Talking there with Shuichi Gonda, the keeper, who is just about the man to take over between the pipes. Just the three changes, as I say, for Japan today. And they are as follows. The changes from the last game. See the likes of Hidemasa Morita come in, Junior Ito come in, and Ayo Tanaka coming into the side. They are replacing these three players, which is Shibasaki, who moves out, Kamada, who goes out as well, and Asano, who goes to the bench as well. The Australians there, the Socceroos, they upset the apple cart way back when they came in. And I tell you, they've had 2 wins in all their head-to-heads over the years, both in Australian soil, 2-1 and 3-1 against Japan. But it's Japan who really harbour back to that one in 2006 on the 12th of June, when Australia won a World Cup group game against Japan by 3-1 and went on to have a really, really good World Cup. Japan's World Cup record, well, they've made it to the World Cup group stage, the full-blown World Cup in 98, 2002, 2006, 10, 14 and 18. But the furthest they've got is the round of 16 after their group games. Didn't participate, just the last game. They beat Serbia 1-0 in a friendly back in June this year, although their last 3 games, Japan have lost to Oman at home, just about beat Chinese People's Republic away from home, and Saudi Arabia turned them over when they visited there last time on the 7th of October. So it is a big, big win game for Haji Moriyasu's side, ranked 24 in the world. It is a big ask for them today. They're up against Australia, who are ranked 9 places below them, but the 58-year-old Graham Arnold, who played 54 times with 19 goals for Australia, been in charge since 2018. He also played 1 year with Hiroshima, but most of his years were spent with Sydney United. You have to go back a long way since Australia last tasted defeat, but for sure, 3-1 against Oman, and if that's the form line for you, with Japan losing at home to Oman, it should be a walk in the park, they say, for Australia, but these games have got to be won. I'm sure a point for them today will certainly make the game a lot more impressive. Japan head out, and they have some stars amongst their lineup, with the Arsenal player Takahiro Tomiyasu, and of course Maya Shida, once of Southampton in the Premier League, and Takumi Minamino with Liverpool, the former champions in the Premier League. They have some players that can do some damage as well, but then again, Australia, most of their side are playing and playing their trade in foreign climes anyway. They make 2 changes today. Ryan Grant and Awer Mabil are dropping to the bench to be replaced by Fran Karacic at right back, and Adam Moy, who comes into midfield.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the national anthem. The National Anthem of Commonwealth of Austria.
National anthems will be taking place very shortly. And the two sides link arms. Bright yellow shirts and green shorts, olive green shorts, and bright yellow socks for Australia. Rogic there, Karadžić brought back in, Taggart, all of them singing, and Matt Ryan, formerly of Brighton, now playing with Real Sociedad in La Liga. Started the last four games, and Graham Arnold with his mask on as well. Nice to have some fans back in. There has been no fans inside the stadium for quite a long time, but in Japan, we are back. We are ready. Harry Suter, former English player, well, still English player, playing with Stoke City in fairness. He scored six goals in five appearances, the centre half. So he's got to be looking good. Now it's time for the Japanese national anthem. The players get themselves together. There's always something really, really excellent and stirring about the national anthems before these internationals. And it really is a big game. I cannot express just how big this game is for today's sides. Two lineups up there for you now. Normal shape, Gonda in goal, Yoshida and Tomiyasu, your two centre-halves, Nagamoko and Sakai are your full-backs. Endo and Morita will play in the engine room behind Minamino, Tanaka and Ito, and Asako, the man tasked with getting the goals today. Your referees today. Abdul Rahman Ali Jassim is your referee, assisted by Taleb Salam Almari and Syed Ahmed Al Makwale, all from Qatar. Fourth official is Syed Ali H.J. Al Abda. And of course, the fourth official, Mr. Monitor Man, as I would call him, sat around there at home. Kamis Mohamed Almari, he's also the man to look at it. Let's have a quick look at the two sides now. We'll go back to the Australian side. Normal lineup for them. Ryan in goal, Sainsbury and Suter, your two centre halves. Karadžić record to right back and Behic on the left. Irvine and Moy will go through the centre. And then it will be Rustic, Rogic and Boyle in behind Adam Taggart at the top of the park. What a two sides just now. Have a little bit of a look into their huddles. It's all about the next 90 minutes for these two, and I can't really tell you just how important it is for the Japanese side to get something out of today's game. You look at the table, they sit I say lowly, they're joint third. There's three of them on 3 points, Japan, Oman and China. Vietnam seem to be the whipping boys at the moment. They will be off to play Oman later. Australia lead the way with Saudi Arabia with 9 points from their three games so far. Well, the two sides away. I'm looking at the pitch very much as you're seeing any televisual pictures here. Manji Moriyasu, the 53-year-old. He played 35 times for Japan. He played most of his career with Hiroshima as well. And we're off and running. Was that Borton, I think. Junior Ito back in after being suspended, but not involved in the September games. Any chance there, and it's going to be Rogic that tries to come away with the ball, but he's just upended in the middle of the park there. Moriyasu will feel a little bit of pressure at the moment. Surely that was an awkward one, but Boyle's got inside his man there. Fighting hard there with Yuto Nagamoto. Frank Karacic comes in. Decent ball in fairness. Oh, Shuichi Gendo has played it straight out here to Moy. Going for the set, but that's going to be easily headed away. That would rather a poor punch there by Shuichi Gonda. Moy cuts it out again, and it's a little bit ragged at the moment from Japan. Suit up to Sainsbury. Suit up goes on this near side. Put a stick, Irvine. And back to his Irvine. Fair hitch. Australia just getting their foot on the ball now. Suter will go back to Ryan. Forward long and strong. Taggart is the target. Easily taken off the ball there by the centre half, Yoshida, but it's Australia that pick up a gate. Lovely footwear there from Rogic. Is he claimed off the ball? The referee says no. Australia trying to build again. They've seen much of the football in this first 2 minutes here. Moy, Behic. Moy again. They're playing his trade in Shanghai Port in China. Spells in the Premier League in England with Huddersfield Town. Look on the far side, Minamino. Kind of want to settle themselves down. They would love an early goal here. Tomiyasu. To Yoshida. Sakai. Yoshida. Tomiyasu. Tomiyasu plays normally on the right-hand side. Left side, so he's always going to be awkward receiving the ball from his right-sided centre-half. Long ball up this time. Yuya Asako trying to find Junior Ito. Takes it into stride, he's past Behic. Ito driving forward. A little bit of a loose cross in behind Asako. Junior Ito there. Really did get away from Behic, just one little touch, nice hold-up plate, played it in. It's almost just a hit-and-run moment, but his pace is too much for as-is Behic. Danger signs there for Australia. Karacic. Doesn't make the Australian man, but it's Japan now will be buoyed by that opening exchange there. Tanaka, Yoshida and Tanaka just exchanging passes. It's Tomiyasu wants it on his right foot a lot. Could be pressure put to bear on his left foot when a ball is played in there. Tanaka down the line and rampaging forward down here. The right back getting himself forward, Hiroki Sakai. Some real pressure on now. Sakai will take the throw. Ito trying to run behind Behic again. Suter's got himself in a real tangle. And it's the first corner. That's the Australia's to be area of dominance here. Having said that, commentator's curse, first person to come in the back is Wataru Endo, who gets a free header. Anybody out there now from Japan or want more of that against the Australians by your commentator? Anybody in Australia, tell me quite quickly to keep quiet. Tanaka plays for Fortuna Dusseldorf in the second tier of the Bundesliga. And then you sub in the game against Saudi Arabia. Gets his chance today. Taggart tries to bring this down. Again, Tanaka with the first header, gets onto the wall quickly. Minamino. Japan certainly on the front foot here. First 6 minutes, they've had the first corner of the game. Nagamoto with the throw. Easy for Karacic to clear. It's controlled by Taggart, but he has been well marshalled. Put a stick, it's a strong challenge in the middle of the park. Minamino, the man that was a little bit lively with the challenge. I think the follow through and the intent was what got the whistle. Taggart finds himself on the turf, expecting the underfoot surface. Australia haven't really got their players on there. Covered them earlier in the tournament. Rogic, Vustic, very talented players to mix with the grit of Jackson Irvine. Adam Moyes, a decent player as well, but a little touch there gives a throw to Australia. Sainsbury to Suter. And Sainsbury gets it back, and it's going to have to go all the way back to Matt Ryan. Good pressure from Junior Ito there, applauded by the fans inside the Saitama Stadium. Not full by any means, but certainly not empty. Minamino. It's going across the face, as it's missed it. Real charge, 1-0. What a finish by Ayo Tanaka. And as is Behic, he's the man that's missed the ball across the face of the Australian box and just left the man Ayo Tanaka in absolute acres of space. We have got a VAR checking it. But let's be honest with you, as is Behic, he could well have a real saving grace here. No way is Tanaka offside there when the ball is played. Lovely finish, right across the face of the goal. Just a toe off of Irvine. Behic caught out, and Ayo Tanaka with an absolute crisp finish. Japan lead, can't see that one being chalked up. Man in your picture there, as is Behic, has already found Junior Ito's pace a little too hot to handle. And this time he's got himself sucked under and into the middle of the pitch for his penalty area. Although there was a slight deflection off of Irvine's toe. missed his kick, and Japan already a goal to the good here in this derby. What a fine finish it was as well. Can Japan force home their advantage here? Inside 10, they're a goal to the good. Jim Moriyasu will be over the moon. Behich has got to try and deal with it here, and he's played to Taggart. Taggart now. Can he pick a pass? He's got help there. Rustic finds Jackson Irvine. Irvine tries a rather straight ball into Rogic, but it's cut out far too easy, slightly misplaced. Australia currently 11 wins on the spin. That's a pretty impressive record. They're going to have to work very hard in this one now, because it's Japan that have started on the front foot. In a game, really, that Japan need to win more than Australia do. Takahiro Tomiyasu. Yoshida now just exchanging passes. Tanaka. It's a man that seems to be looming up at right back. Murray Suter. Sainsbury. I see a lot here. Rustic goes in. Strong challenge going in there. Just got his body across the ball. And your referee today, Abdulrahman Al-Jassim. Very quickly to see it. Forwards challenge, they might say. That would have hurt. That would have spanned his toes there. Sarko, the man that tried to get the challenge in. Cross from Minamino off the toe there of Irvine. Behich with an awful challenge. Lovely first touch there. Set himself beautifully. And Tanaka drilled it low past Ryan. Japan took the lead. No wonder they are happy. Australia just seem a little stung by that early goal from Japan. They just seem to be measuring their game. They don't want to go rushing things forward, but by being measured and maybe disciplined with their approach work, that's allowing Japan to have a high press on them. Good work on the far side, though, now. Boyle. Looking hard on the far side, gets a throw for Australia. Graham Arnold not so happy on the touchline. Mask off, faced with a grimace. Boyle gets it again. Frank Karadžić with the throw now. What can he do? Hasn't got a lot of bodies in the penalty area. He's aiming for Taggart. Taggart lays it off. What a fine volley that is as well. Couldn't quite keep it down. Tom Rogic, the Celtic man. Nice set, in fairness, by Adam Taggart. Rogic had to take it early, couldn't wait for it. When you're volleying the football, you want to try and hit it at the lowest point. It is a corner to Australia. Must have just taken a wee deflection. Moy to take. Strong header at the back post and turned over. Gonda just made it. It's Trent Sainsbury that got his head well above his man. He's got a drop under the crossbar, but Shuichi Gonda elects to turn it over the bar. Two corners in quick succession now for Australia. Got a stick to take it. Poor corner. He's going to get a second chance, though, from a better angle. Whips it in. And that really did need saving. Shuichi Gonda really twigged that that was going to be rattled in again. And Ajdin Rusnik fancied his chances there. Good delivers a better ball this time towards Sainsbury. Soutal wins the header, turned on by Irvine, and just ushered past the post. Good defensive work there, just made sure his man was behind him. Just allowed that ball to go across his man. Otaro Undo just making sure that he can get his body across the man there. Good defending, knew exactly where Taggart was, and just held him off. Australia with a little bit of purpose there. Three corners in quick succession. Moy now. Very patient crowd. I have to say that inside the Saitama Stadium, very quiet, studious crowd. Not much vocality coming from them. Tomiyasu heads it away. Australia, though, don't just maybe seeing more football. Irvine to get involved. Four passes there from Australia just to finally get it. Fifth pass gets it to Behic on this near side. Should be easy for Yoshida just to see out, but he's elected to keep it in play. Nicely played. Endo to Takehiro Tomiyasu. Endo with all the time in the world here to pick his passes. And although the possession, as you can see, is in favour of the Socceroos, it's Japan that have that all-important goal. Karacic with the header. Put a stick. He's got a lot to his right if he can see it. He could, but couldn't deliver. Japan finding everybody's foot at the moment. Oh, that one there was just lifted too long there for Yuya Osako. Rogic. Far side, it's Boyle. Good work on the far side. He is just about popping up everywhere at the moment. Ayo Tanaka. I'll have to say that that was a foul. The drums are on in the Saitama Stadium. Would have seen this venue in the Summer Olympics football tournament. Rogic, little layoff to Hrustic. Suits up. Could be a long afternoon, though, if Japan decide to accept all the pressure from the Socceroos. Rogic now with a chance to play it in. Karacic now with another chance, but he's got to take on Tanaka. He gets past Tanaka rather easy. Good ball in. Don't let the feet there of Taggart, who couldn't control. Hooked away from Japan. What feels it, one goal is not going to be enough for either side in this game. Behic to Moy. Good defensive work there by Sakai. At the moment it's Japan that pick up a lot of the second balls, although this time the inadvertent touch there by Abdul Rahman Al-Jazim means he's going to bring it back. Poor touch there. Really should have read that a bit better there, the old referee. Tried it with the outside of the boot. Always the instep for a good first touch. You've got possession of the football then, ref. Takehiro Tomiyasu. Yoshida. An interesting game plan from the Socceroos and Graham Arnold. They won't have enjoyed the fact that they trailed into that 8th-minute goal by Ayo Tanaka. He had some game plan in place. Just looking a little bit off kilter at the moment. Aaron Moy steals in there. Irvine to Karadzic. Japan offer the early ball into the box from the two wide full backs for Australia, but Sam will have it in front of us if he can. Karadzic there with a loose touch just moments ago, could have put the ball in early, but there's only one target up there, and that's Taggart. Sainsbury receives it, Royan gives it in back. It's a good press from Japan. Possessional stats always can be a little bit off-putting, because you could have possession in the final third of your own half and really go nowhere with it. You can rack up the passes as well. And Australia's higher percentage rate on the football, primarily, I would say, has happened inside their own half. Van Karadzic going forward now. 25-year-old, plays for Brescia in the second division in Italy. Just again, a little triangle of passes, one side to the other of the halfway line, and width is provided here by the right back Karadzic. But again, you don't need telling that Australia, yet again, they trail by a goal to nil. They're playing football just around the halfway line. Plenty of time to get an equaliser, but you've got to be a very good side to manage to change your tempo in games. Whilst it's all nice and getting a good first touch and enjoying time on the football, they're allowing Japan to come out and press high and not yet mind finding the ball to spring into the space behind them. Behic. But again, no one going down the channel, nobody making a forward run. It's back to Suter. Australians known for their aggressive sporting style in the world of rugby union, rugby league, cricket, whatever they play it to win. Ito now with a chance, gets inside his man nicely, opened his body up well, but obviously you can see it wasn't the crispest of finishes there, but again, turned inside of Harry Suter quite easily. We all could see what he wanted to do. In step of the left foot into Ryan's top right-hand corner. But alas, it wasn't as accurate as he'd hoped for. Ajdin Hrustić. Give a go with Moy. Maybe Graham Arnold's plan is to stay in the game. Raise a terrific ending, but they won't be happy with the goal that was conceded. It was a mistake, a little bit of an error from Aziz Behic, who missed the ball that came across the face of goal. But Ayo Tanaki really did finish it well. With the long ball, I'm tagged out jump there by Tomiyasu. Nicely played there to get away from his man, but he's given it away to Junior Ito. Tomiyasu to Yoshida. Minutes on the clock, still Tanaka's goal separating the two. Decent play here, crossed it. Oh, that's a good take there by Ryan. Had to get there before Yuya Asako. And Japan seemed to carry the bigger threat. In the final third, Ito with a lovely bring down. Endo. Ryan takes this time. No right just a moment ago here. On the far side, Nagamoto just span, whipped it in, and it's really in the right place. Expect Sainsbury to do a little bit more. We'll get more of a chat from Ryan. Centre forward there. Yu Asaka was going in between the two. A little bit lackluster from the Australians. I want to see a little bit more baring of their teeth to their opposition. 1-0 is 1-0. That's no lead at all. Tomiyasu do Yoshida. But Japan are almost being allowed to play it at a pedestrian pace. When it goes the other way, when it's Australia, Japan are pressing. That's a lovely spin on the turn there. Tanaka. Ito. Sakai. Ito again with a chance to go forward. Sakai there just eases the ball back, and again it's played square. Australia might say, well, we're seeing the ball in front of us, so it's easy. Nagamoto, Tomiyasu. Ito's stolen in behind Behic. Is the flag going to go up? Indeed it does. This is Behic on this near side. He's been having a little bit of a day. Plays for Giresunspor in Turkey. Won't want to see that goal again. It did flick off the toe of Jackson Irvine across the face of goal, but still, it was a little bit of an air shot from Behic, and it fell sweetly at the feet of Ayo Tanaki, who just took a touch and then rifled it across the face of goal, right-footed. But again, it's Japan that pick up the ball. It's sloppy play from Australia. Ito. Hiroki Sakai. Japan playing nicely within themselves. They know that it's for Australia now to try and come out and make something happen. Endo. Very, very busy. To use a little bit of ice hockey parlance, they are going from tape to tape, Japan, at the moment. It's into the feet every time. Yoshida, Nagamoto stealing forward again, followed by Boyle. Minamino. In the end, will they see it out? In the end, that's great play back there. I've got to say, Yuya Osako with Trent Sainsbury. Didn't give it up, and in the end, forced an error from Sainsbury to get the corner. Second corner of the game. Just go short. Behic manages to get the ball away, but it's not really that safe. Takumi Minamino will retrieve the situation. Nagamoto with the deep ball in, far too long. Tanaka, goal scorer, but at the moment it's just a little bit one-way traffic. You just feel the greater threat between the two sides is coming from the host, Japan. Australia have really yet to rattle Japan. They had three corners in quick succession. Haven't really managed to find any penetration against the Japanese back four. Nice ball out there. Behic took it well, but again, he could be forced to look back towards his own goal for assistance. But a stick goes back to Trent Sainsbury. heard Graham Arnold there above the crowd saying that Trent was open. Jackson Irvine, again, the press is there. Man closing the ball down at every opportunity. Bit of space this time. But a stick trying to go forward. Can he open up for a left-footed shot? Win it back. Feeds it out to Jackson Irvine. No, he leaves it to Fran Karacic. Put a stick. Rogic round a corner to Moy. Moy manages to evade the challenge of Ito and gets it out here to Bezic. Well read there by Maya Shida, who's now going to break away with the football as well. Rocky Sakai, I beg your pardon. Endo's just dwelling on it a touch. Wanted something out to his left-hand side, and Nagamutu was a little slow on the premise. Zoro Endo back to Maya Shida. Morita looking for Junior Ito. Ito gets across, but Suter's got the bounce of the ball in his favour, the Australian centre-half, and heads it away. Well, the performance from Japan belies the opening three games in this group. Just the one victory and two defeats. The victory over China. The defeat to Oman in Saudi Arabia. You've left that man in your picture there. Hajin Moriyasu under a little bit of pressure. Uganda. Sakai. Yoshida. Tomiyasu. No pressure on the ball. You've only got a look at it. And, Yuta Nagamoto back inside to Takahiro Tomiyasu. Now there's a bit of pressure on the ball, but they've picked their way through this quite easily. Yuta Nagamoto now. Minamino. Almost as though it's a two-man press instead of three-man at time. Bit of time and space here. Junior Ito. To play the ball early, couldn't. Sakai goes back to Maya Shida. And the left back, Yuto Nagamoto, again provides a willing outlet. Can he take on Boyle? He can. He drags the ball back into a dangerous position. Chance here for Yuya Sako. Ito with another chance. Australia under a bit of pressure here. Behic and Moy manage to smuggle the ball away. Tug at the target. Graham Arnold won't be happy with the turnover of the football here from the Australians, but as you can see again, 56-57% virtually possession for Australia, but it's got to be in the right place. That's a very misleading stat. That stat that currently is in the top left hand corner of your screen is the one that matters. 1-0 to Japan, scored by Ayo Tanaka after just 8 minutes. Back's on his way again, puts a lot of pressure on. That's excellent play, and that's terrific defensive work in the end by Fran Karacic. Yuto Nagamoto. Shida marshalling things really well. It's a one-man press from Australia, and as it goes back there to Takahiro Tomiyasu, he's got a good 5 or 6 metres around him to take his time to play the ball. Yoshida, time to pick his pass down the line. Ito tries to get it back to the centre-forward there, Osako, but Australia have picked their pockets this time. Horistic has his pick. Now is a real chance. Osako driving forward. He's got support. Osako, right-foot shot, and he puts it wide. He'll be very, very disappointed with that one. Excellent picking of the pocket by Wataru Endo. Sainsbury's done enough to try and get something onto it, and in the end it's a very uncomfortable right foot effort by Yuya Asako. But again the threat is carried by Japan, and Australia with a greater possession still have yet to get too close to Shuichi Gonda's goal. And that'll be something Graham Alexander will be looking to change in the coming minutes. 10 minutes until we get to the halfway point of the game. Nagamoto. Irvine gets it forward. Nagamoto once again. Minion with a toe there. So fall nicely for Moy. That's his bare hitch now. A little bit of time and space to drive forward. Moy makes the run inside. Ito Nagamoto heads it away before Irvine can get there. Minamino lifts it over the top. Sarko's the target. Ryan's out. Good starting position. And a nice header in fairness away. Australia thwart that one. This time Nagamoto's a little too stiff with the challenge on Martin Boyle. The Australian goes down. Although I'm not so sure in any other walk of life whether those two hands on his back would have meant such a pronounced fall to the floor. Sainsbury to suit up. Australia have got to pick up their tempo, one feels. Suter again. Lovely turn around the corner by Boyle. Taggart won't get there. Excellent marshalling of the defence back there. The right-sided centre-half, Mayo Shida, 111th appearance today. Gets across well. There's a face of a man that's maybe a little concerned, Graham Arnold. For a side that's 111 on the spin, they're either very, very confident in what they're doing. The first three games they've won it in the group, in fairness, against the bottom three sides in Group B table. Yoshida. Tanaka, but again, you see Yoshida, nobody advances on him. Easily can find a pass to the left side of centre-half there. Takahiro Tomiyasu. Nagamoto's on the way again. Good ball in, too high for Asako. Behich has got to get it away. And does so, but not out of play. Hiroki Sakai. It just appears at the moment as though every time Japan want to just up the ante a bit, they can do. Aided and abetted, it has to be said, by their fleet-footed left-back Yuto Nagamoto, who's providing a real outlet down the Australian right. Irvine. Roger gets it to Karacic. Karacic continues. Now it's a little play with Hulistic. Irvine into the feet of Moy, who's coming off this near side. Been playing predominantly left, but turns up centrally there. That's well to get to the ball, but again, some play on the far side to clear it from Japan. And Yuya Asako's got away from Trent Sainsbury's in splendid isolation there, though. And he's done really, really well. And he's got Minamino with him. Endo comes with support. Appreciative applause there from the Japanese crowd. Oh, a smattering, I mean just a smattering of Australian fans there. Ito's ball. Tanaka on his heels somewhat. Look at that, the two men with the tiny topknots on their head there, Behich and Irvine. But a real tempting pass for Japan to steal, but it's Karacic now that goes forward. Even when I had hair, I don't think I'd have gone for a tiddly topknot. Really my look. Wataru Endo there. Plays it against the legs of Karacic. Nice one on the far side, says that is a throw to Japan. Graham Arnold looks a man a little bit worried. Often managers can see and sense there's no zip, no spring, no bounce. But at the moment, Australia are a side that are not giving the impression that they're really hitting their straps presently. Ashin Hrustic is coming very deep there to try and play the ball, but to go back to Suter. Suter will play it to Ryan, who will make a third centre-half for a moment. Suter's looking forward, but again, he elects to go short there to Hrustic. Sainsbury and Suter again, it's possession, it's another three passes racked up, four if you include the one back to Ryan there, but it's all in their final third for Australia. Bezic. And now possibly Graham Arnold to tell you that might happen when we play a ball to nothing. Excellent work there by Yuya Osaka, finds Takumi Minamino. Support here by Morita. Nagamoto joins the attack again. Shida receives it. Now comes the press from Rogic. Stefan Karadzic gets the ball down to Martin Boyle. Boyle's found Taggart. Taggart with a chance here to find Rogic. Rogic gets it back to Taggart. Taggart! Off the post, Moy! Great block on this near side. That's the closest Australia have come. For the first time they've really played the counter-attack in football. Will that give them some belief for the Socceroos? Karadzic delivers. Headed the wave this time. Rogic into the feet of Irvine. Japan under a bit of pressure. Karadzic goes for a rather audacious attempt. Boyle found Taggart. Lovely exchange of play there with Rogic. Taggart, good, got it down well. And I'm going to say that Shuichi Gonda got something on that, and I'm absolutely right. Caught the outside of his left hand. We just see a replay of the goal. That's how it should be done when you're going across the face of goal. Ayo Tanaka with it on 8 minutes, which pleased the fans, but just a moment, those fans would have been gripping their seats a little bit hard as Taggart's effort hit the post. Well, a man that looks impeccably dressed and very calm there in your picture, Haji Moriyasu, would have felt increasingly worried as that ball went into the box. Well played between Boyle and Taggart and Rogic. For the first time, the Australians may be buoyed by some of their on-field play. They've been pretty lethargic in this first 42 minutes. That little moment where Gonda's placed Taggart's shot against the post just shows you how slender the 1-0 lead is. Nagamoto. Morita back to Nagamoto. Tanaka's first touch has allowed it to be stolen off him. Ataro Endo, though, doing his job well. Takumi Minamino. Junior Ito on this near side. Behic again under pressure. Minamino gets it back. Good effort from Minamino. Good save there by Ryan. Captain of Australia down well to his left-hand side there. As he turned, you do fancy Minamino was looking towards Ryan's top right-hand corner, but he got over the ball and took it down to his bottom left, and it was well read by Ryan. Corner laid on here. Tanaka to take. Come on, come on, Really cleared by Australia. Tanaka wins it back. He's going to see it out for a throw. A little bit of evidence for you, exactly what Australia will take out of today's game as the ball rolled towards Graham Arnold there. Just let it roll through his legs and away into the dugout behind him. And that'd have been a goal down. He'd have trapped that and passed it straight back. He's now received the ball. First 45 have almost elapsed. Good turn there by Osaka. Ito. Osaka back to goal. Game well played. Endo chance here. And it's smuggled back to Matt Ryan. Had some impressive performances in the first half. The goal scorer Tanaka has popped up just about everywhere all over the park. The left-back Yuto Nagamoto has been influential a lot. Just a minimum of 1 minute to be added on here at the end of the first half here in the Saitama Stadium. 1-0 to Japan. Got a stick to Karacic. Irvine. Trent Sainsbury wants an out ball. Angle just cut off there by Minamino. Symptomatic of Australia's first half performance. An awful lot of football played in their own half. Just the one flurry of excitement when Adam Taggart hit the post for the referee today. Abdulrahman Al-Jassim of Qatar says that's enough. And at the break here, it is the Japanese side that lead by the Ao Tanaka goal on 8 minutes that will go off the happier. The two opposing coaches have different team talks to make at halftime. Japan will be asked to keep up to the mark and not slack off in any way, shape or form. Australia will be asked to lift that tempo. But it is Tanaka's goal that separates the two here inside the Saitama Stadium. And it's all down to those gentlemen, Graham Arnold for Australia and Haji Moriyasu for Japan, to go and pep up the troops. After the first 45 minutes was definitely the better for Japan. Australia, just the one effort. Adam Taggart off the post, saved by the man that just walks out of your picture there, Shuichi Gonda. Well, the first 45 has elapsed. Another break with the two sides making their way off the field of play. Japan 1, Australia 0. Ao Tanaka after just 8 minutes. Welcome back here to the Saitama Stadium. Mai Yoshida leads out the side that are 1-0 up, courtesy of Ao Tanaka's goal on 8 minutes. Japan, whose start to the Group B qualifying has been a little bit of a stuttering start, lead the favourites Australia by a goal to nil. And it is a fair reflection of that first half that the dangerous side were indeed the host Japan. Australia went through most of the first half being rather sedentary with their play. Only once opening up on 41, Japan's rear guard, when Taggart fired a shot in just to see Shuichi Gonda pop it onto the post, and Moi saw his block-up shot as it came back off the post, blocked by Wataru Endo. But that man in your picture, Ao Tanaka, profited from a little bit of a wild swing from, as is Behic, as the ball was crossed into the box. Fired low past Matt Ryan on just 8 minutes. This would be a real, real big fillip here for Japan. It's 3 points will take them closer to the side. The Socceroos at the top of the table currently. And will give them hope. Plenty of games still to come for both sides. After this, it's Vietnam away for Japan and then Oman away for Japan. They end up their qualifying campaign here against the Chinese People's Republic and Saudi Arabia. And the second half is underway. Just run through the lineups for you. For Japan, in goal is Shuichi Gonda. Right fullback Hiroki Sakai. And on the left, it's Yuto Nagamoto, who was very, very impressive in the first half. Terrific energy. The two centre-halves are Takahiro Tomiyasu and Maya Yoshida. In the middle of the park, it is Ayo Tanaka and Wataru Endo. Junior Ito hailing him from the right-hand side. Hidemasa Morita in the middle, and Takumi Minamino. Those are the three tasked with the job in behind Yuya Asako at the top of the park. For the Socceroos, it's Matt Ryan in goal. From left to right, Aziz Behic, Harry Suter, Trent Sainsbury and Fan Karacic. Then it's Aaron Moy and Jackson Irvine with Ashton Hrustic, Tom Rogic and Martin Boyle. And Taggart at the top of the park. Referee today, well, they all come from Qatar. Abdul Rahman Al-Jassim, Talib Salam Al-Mahri, Saud Ahmed Al-Mar Kwale, Saud Ali H. Al-Adba. And fourth official is, that was him just there, the VAR is Kamis Mohamed Al-Mahri. They are the way forward. Japan on the attack again. Minamino delivers, flicks off the head of Suta. Behic will have to deal with it. Good work by Ito. Excellent work on the far side of gate. Moy kept in possession, but Ryan's got time just to lay it forward. And Jackson Irvine, who, in my mind, in the first half, spent an awful long time looking for the ball backwards instead of forwards. Graham Arnold will now have been whispering in the ears of the Socceroos. I wouldn't say whispering, I think it could have been more of a bellow. They want a little bit more. That's when Australia did up the ante. Just a moment, they've hit the post. Suter again. For a Socceroos fan, you'll be disappointed with the fact that, again, Irvine's gone straight back to Sainsbury. They need to pick a pass a little further forward. Easy header away on the far side by Hiroki Sakai. Their hitch. My figure of Taggart as the man he's aiming for, but generally the back four has been marshalled really well by the former Southampton player. Maya Yoshida now playing with Sampdoria. Hajime Moriyasu will be looking for his side just to maybe pop this game to bed. 2-0's never an easy scoreline to be in front by, but with what has come from the opposite directions than the Socceroos, you see them struggling at the moment to get one. Two would be well beyond them, you feel. Moy, Behic, Hrustic. Moy again. Behic is there. Moy's going to make a run. His slightly aging legs going forward there. 31 years of age now, Adam Moy. That's a decent ball from Karacic. Oh, but it's just given away. Or should I be a little bit more complimentary about Yoshida's positioning? Takumi Minamino. Just upending Fran Karacic here. Japan will not want to wait to their goal being opened up by easy and cheap free kicks given away in and around their 18-yard box. A rivalry between these two that goes back to 2006 in the Asian Confederation when Australia joined. Just before that, and it was a big victory for Australia by 3-1 in 2006 that really started these two having a rather intense time. Australia, though, although having won 11 on the spin, have never won on Japanese soil. Frank Karacic with a throw. You can see the Australian fans just behind him there. Irvine doesn't get there, it's allowed to bounce. It's cleared by Yoshida. Morita got it a little further away. Nagamoto gets it forward. Rustic tries to keep it in play. Sainsbury manages to get it to Rogic. It's knocked wide on the far side to Moy. Chance here for Moy. Has gone to going down to his left-hand side. Fancy those Shuichi Gonja. And it covered, you can just see actually as he goes down, he pulls his right arm away from the football. Graham Arnold with the one-man Mexican way there on the wrong side of the pitch. Was waiting for the net to billow. Minamino now, chance to take on Karacic, goes early, looking for Osaku. But I talk about tempo in football matches, and it's the tempo of Japan when they go forward, as opposed to the tempo of Australia, which has been by far the most telling point for your commentator, Andrew Self, here in the commentary box. Pedestrian, sedentary, whatever you want to say about Australia, they've been a little bit lackluster for a side that's won their last 11. They have it within their locker, as Taggart showed. That's a loose ball back, just enough on it. Gonda will come out and just play it long. They need to just up the tempo a touch, the Australians. Just make Japan think somewhat. Ito the target. The hitch clears. Sakai backs him up. Goal-scorer Tanaka has popped up just about everywhere on the field of play. Finds Ito. Shida. Almost picking out Ito. Nagamoto. Good work on this near side. Excellent work, in fairness, by Hidemasa Morita. Nagamoto again popping up from left back inside the Australian penalty area. 35 years of old age now, plays for FC Tokyo, debut in 2008. Belies the fact that he's got 35-year-old legs, because he's been up and down this flank repeatedly. Taggart trying to get in behind Yoshida, and if there is anything there for the Australians to pick up, Taggart's got the feet on Yoshida in a foot race. Morita. Tomiyasu. Nagamoto. Morita again. Getting away on this near side from Hristic, who surely brought him down. Referee today, Abdulrahman Al-Jassim from Qatar, says he did indeed. Seeing the face there, the belief that is there inside this Japanese side. If you've ever played a team sport, you know when you're on the up. You know when you're in control. It doesn't mean you're safe. Means you have to cement that ability to go further in front and keep your game management there, but at the moment they are in control of this qualifier against Australia. Free kick is taken in. Great header there. Well, he may well hold his head in his hands there, Hiroki Sakai. Lovely delivery by Tanaka. Just heads it on the way down, which means it's always going to go up from his forehead. But Australia, who I fancied to be aerially superior to Japan, well, found wanting there with a straightforward free kick into their own penalty area. Mm-hmm. Which gets the ball away. You heard the applause for him. Hidemasa Morita is going to leave it to Yuta Nagamoto, but it's the Australian bench now that are trying to work out their next move. Minamino with a nice bit of skill. Lovely play now, Tanaka, Ito. Osaka's in there. Osaka lets it run. Is there a foul behind the ball? Minamino's gone down. He wants something. He's not going to get it. Morita. Sainsbury with a header away. Moy turns it long. I have to say, I was following the ball. I didn't see Takumi Minamino hit the deck. Not even sure that Abdulrahman Al-Jassim has got his finger to his ear. Takumi Minamino thought there was some interference as he broke into the box. Karadzic. Karadzic caught in possession, but he's managed to win it back. Minamino grounded there. And Irvine goes back yet again to Sainsbury. Looking for Taggart through the centre. Tomiyasu clears. It is a very, very good side that can pick tempos up. You often see it straight after the break and a change of words in their ear holes at half-time. But Australia still going a little bit sidewards and backwards. Karadzic. Rogic. What idea, wrong execution. In fairness to Behic, he almost stole the ball off of Sakai there. But it's Ito now going the other way. Marcin Hrustic was a man that blocked his path. Had a quiet game for me, Hrustic. It's Eintracht Frankfurt. Jackson Irvine looked to be the one. Just had a shot on my replay monitor here. But Takumi Minamino. Of course, there as well, Haji Moriyasu. Something that wasn't seen. Tanaka, Osaku. Ito tries to get in behind, as is Behic, who clears the ball away. But again, a more purposeful endeavour comes from Japan going forward. A lot more zip and tempo about the way Japan attack the Australian rear guard. Simba Vane to the first 45 for his side, Graham Arnold. Moy manages to get a foot in there. Taggart's fed it far side. Moy won't get there. Itaro Endo clears the ball, but it's decent work in the middle of the park there for Australia. Suits up. Speed just goes up. The drums are there. It's a massive stadium. Holds around about 63,700 people. Not completely full. It's nice to see the fans back in. Taggart can't win the ball near. Yoshida heads it away. Ballistic loses out in a battle with Tanaka, but Moy feeds Behic. Behic in. Little layoff. Moy can't get their chance here for Rogic. Well, he's caught hold of it, and I don't need to tell you he's caught hold of it. Just bobbling the ball, and he's put it high over Gonda's crossbar. First change possibly of the game coming on. Furuhashi being lined up to come on. The Celtic man. Tanaka. Ito's got the legs on Behic. We saw that in the first half, but Trent Sainsbury's read the danger, gets it back to Ryan. And Karadzic trying to play it up to the halfway line, but again, it's just not sticking for Australia. Still plenty of time, though, at least half an hour to go. But Australia will want to just raise things a little more. The work rate and endeavour from the Japanese side has been very, very good. They're closing down the first 45 minutes was excellent. It might lose a little bit of zip in the second 45 as some legs get tired. Nagamoto thumps it away. Sainsbury, Irvine. A chance now for Hrustic, bit of space to go forward this time. The closing down's not that good. That's a nice step in there by Wataru Endo. And the first change of the day does come. Osako Yuya going up. And he will be replaced by the man at the top of the park, Kyogo Furuhashi. Come on, the 26-year-old Celtic player. 3 goals in 9 full appearances for Japan. And Awoma Bill is coming on for Australia. He's going to replace Aaron Moy. Taggart's race is run as well. Mitchell Duke comes on to lead the line. Mitchell Duke, 30 years of age now, plays for Fagiano Okuyama in the second division of the Japanese league. First players have come to try and change the complex of the game. Nagamoto down the line. Nagamoto wants some movement. Morita. Oh, nice play now, Yagamoto again. Seems pivotal, the 35-year-old left-back for Japan. Duke can't get that under control. And Nishida will play it all the way back. For want of a better phrase for the Socceroos, you feel they could do with being a little bit more direct. And trying to play it over the back of 4 of Japan. Minamino spreads it out to Ito. That's where their success might come. Behich done again. Wrapped up like a Christmas present, in fairness, by Junior Ito. Behich gets the first card of the match. Look at the shirt, I think, more than the actual physical contact. Chance here for Japan now. From this angle, you do fancy, you've got a mind's eye, a goalkeeper's view there, just a 2-man wall. Japan need to deliver this just between the penalty spot and the 6-yard spot and away from Harry Suter, who's head and shoulders above everybody else back there for both sides. But they haven't been too safe at set pieces. Lifted in again, Ryan will take. Karasic. Terrific work. Furuhashi. Still, Waller remains 1-0. Australia have every opportunity in the game. Rustic to Mabil. With a than Mabil, being held up by his opposite attacking midfielder there, Junior Ito. A little tight there, but good work from Sainsbury, and Irvine gets it out to Karacic. Karacic down this line here, real chance now for Boyle. Boyle's got space to run into. Can he get the ball back? Edge of the box, coming in onto it. Challenge goes in. I think that could well be a penalty kick. The man with the challenge, Hidemasa Morita, upending Ajdin Hurastik. This will be well worth looking again. Where does the challenge take place? Well, I think they're coming together. It's just inside the penalty area for me. That's where the touch is. And it's now all down to Abdul Rahman Al Jassim of Qatar to see where Hidemasa Morita's challenge was. He seems to be quite happy, the referee. I was just saying moments ago how slender a lead can be. And it is a penalty. Suchi Gonda. Has he done his homework? Hajime Moriyasu not happy being told to go back. Martin Boyle to step up. Boyle versus Gonda. The delay will be getting to the Australian. You saw it in his face there. A little bit more time slips away. Plays for Hibernian in the Scottish Premier League. Last goal was versus Oman in the last game. At the start, well, just on the 7th of October. Nerves of steel required now. A free kick has been given. Well, Abdul Rahman Al Jassim. This is as close as you want to see here. I think the contact's right on the line, but it's not my neck on the line. So it is. Of course, the graphics. It's no. It is just definitely a free kick. Still in a dangerous area. In the meantime, Hidemasa Morita has got himself a yellow card. Well, if it gives us the right result, then you can't argue with it. Maybe there's something in me that just likes the spontaneity of that's a decision. Let's go and chew it over a cup of coffee later. Well, it's a different proposition altogether now for Shuichi Gonda. A real gaggle of Australian players around that ball. Very difficult one here, because you can see there the 18-yard box, it's just outside. You'll be very hard pressed to get this up and down. World-class player or not, to get this up and down, it's going to be a tough one. Abdul Rahman Al Jassim making sure the wall is back. You fancy this is going to be a drive from a different angle. Hurastik and Mabil stand over the ball. Rogic is in close proximity. You fancy they'll want to work a different angle and try and get it round the wall with pace and power. What a goal that is. As sweet a goal as you'll see. A lovely take off the underside of the crossbar by Ajdin Hurastik. Who needs a penalty when you can take a free kick like that? Ajdin Hurastik rifles it in off the underside of the park. It's one apiece. And that really was a fine free kick. And that's how slender a lead can be when you've been comfortably on top. Spoke just moments ago that Japan knew they were on top. But that is a fine, fine strike from Hurastik to bring things level. Japan have got to start all over again. Let's see if one side is deflated and one side's buoyed. 20 minutes, regulation minutes left. A game that Japan were controlling, but only with a one-goal advantage. They find themselves staring down the battle of a fraught 20 minutes, you feel. Takeda and Tomiyasu. First time we see a lengthy ball forward. Furuhashi gets there before Behage. Support there from Sakai. Tanaka. Endo. Tomiyasu's ball forward is cut out, but it's given away very quickly there. Tanaka. Endo, Ito, of course a problem for Behage most of this game. Been headed away by Sainsbury, but again it's going to go straight to Endo. Ito to the dead ball line, led to get there as well. Some bring down on this near side by the man that got a yellow card in the lead up to the goal for Australia. Hidemasa Morita. Needs to work after that. I don't know if you know that, that's gone in with pace and power and curl. Shin Hurastik with his second goal for Australia. His last goal was against Kuwait back in June. Plenty for his thoughts now, Haji Moriyasu. Might have fancied his keeper now. If he could take it back, Shuichi Gonda at the penalty kick, because I think Martin Boyle was getting a little fed up waiting for the delay whilst VAR concluded exactly where it was, whether it's a free kick or a penalty. Referee gave the penalty on pitch. VAR said it was outside, and it's a free kick that was given and absolutely sumptuously finished off by Ajdin Hurastik. Loose touch there by Rogic. Furuhashi won't get onto the three ball though. And Irvine. Oh, Hio Tanaka penalised for a heavy challenge there. And fairness, has got away with slight elbow to the upper jaw there of Trent Irvine. Jackson Irvine, I should say. Hio Tomiyasu clears the ball. Martin Boyle eager to get things moving. Body language of both sides is going to be very indicative of how this next 20 minutes is going to unfold. All of a sudden, that goal has given Australia real purpose. And Karacic to launch it into the penalty area again. Minamino loses out. Mitchell Duke puts it in. Mabil. Touch a little heavy, that's a nice clearance as well now. Ito, chance to take on Behic, who's on a card. Tanaka. Endo. Minamino. Nicely read there by Harry Suter, just pulled off his man. Read the danger area and clears it. It's appetising fare between these two. But if the pendulum is swinging. You feel it's right in the middle. It's not actually moving now. Duke with the header down to Mabil. Yoshida with the header away. Kurohashi will chase this down. Ryan's made a little bit of an effort there. Took it back into his own penalty area, as you can see. Loose touch again, pounced on. Real chance now for Endo. Ito! Great save by Ryan. Shot comes in. Great save by Ryan. Endo with the second shot. Ito gets it down again. Can he find Endo for a third time inside the penalty area? And finally, Australia smuggle it away. Rustic with the final tackle. Japan again carrying the bigger threat. It seems in the opponent's penalty area. Irvine into the feet of Mitchell Duke, near side, Karasic gets it in again. Yuta Nagamoto just leathers the ball as far as he can away from his own goal. Japan really causing massive problems again. And Matt Ryan with a terrific double save. There's another change to be made. Takuma Sano is going to come on. Again, Australia's own doing here. Well played by Japan. Ito with the first one, Ryan saves. Endo with the second, Ryan saves. And then it's flashed across the face of goal. Opened up proceedings today to say that Australia would be happy with a point today. Sitch going in and catching a stray boot there from Yuta Nagamoto, but also caught a little slap around the neck, and the man that goes off is Takumi Minamino. And Asano comes on. Asawa, another attacking threat. It's for Bochum in the Bundesliga. Bit of space here now. Rogic driving forward. Tries to thread the Arvenil, but Hitch didn't get there in time, but he's now got the ball. Tomiyasu gets it only to Martin Boyle. Boyle back to Karasic. Chance now for Boyle to take on Tomiyasu. Cross goes in. The deflection done well to take it over the head of Mitchell Duke there. Sainsbury. Boyle. Karasic, Irvine now, space to run forward. Duke comes short. Game just starting to get a little stretched. Good run by Karasic. Nice put in by Tomiyasu. And Asano gets his first touch of the football, indeed his second one very quickly. Endo clips it over the top, great run here. Furuhashi doesn't take the ball with him, still got a chance. Blocked by Sainsbury, shot comes in, Asano sees another fine save by Ryan down to his right-hand side. What a delicious ball by Wataru Endo. Looks like Furuhashi got it wrong. But in the end, the man that's just got onto the field of play, Takana Asano, rifles a shot in which Ryan's done very well. To smother, another glorious chance goes the way of Japan. Matt Ryan's palms have been stinging in the last few moments. The captain's performance in between the posts. from Matt Ryan. That's three decent saves in the space of 4 or 5 minutes. James Diego about to come on for Australia. It's all level as we move into the final 10 minutes of regulation time. Nabil back to Rogic. Tomiyasu will clear. Looking at the form, if you were to put your penny, 8-ni or whatever is the minimal currency you have on a winner here. Japan keep probing. Australia don't. Good ball here. Asano. Into the box. Sainsbury is cool as a cucumber, just scoops the ball away. It's Tom Rogic that's going to go off. To replaced by James Diego. He plays his games in the Greek league with Aris Thessaloniki. In the balance here, just what you want for a football game. If you're a neutral, you just want it poised on it on the edge of a knife here, and it really is. Both sides can snatch it. Yuto Nagamoto's throw didn't look the most convincing one in the rules of association football. Asano's got him behind. Ryan has to come and claim. Takana Asano has proved a little bit of a thorn in the side of Australia. You always want your players off the bench to make a little bit of an impact and or change things around. And so far, you have to say that Mitchell Duke, our Mabil, James Jago's just come on, so it's difficult to say that. They haven't really had the necessary for Australia, whereas Takana Asano's come on, done really well. Furuhashi's had a chance. Just fancy they're changing things up a little better. Kanisic, loose touch there by Suter. Interesting positional there for James Diego. Strong header there by Yuta Nagamoto. She just head her away, and he finds a gold shirt there. It's a strong challenge. And this man is walking a little bit of a tightrope now. Hitomasa Morita. It's just one of those fouls that goes through, but he's on a yellow. Gavu Shibasaki looks as though he's getting ready, as well as Yuta Nakayama. Ball into the Japanese box. Yoshida heads away. Mabil effects a better clearance, although he didn't want to. Diego finds Behic. From the halfway line, as you can see, goes back to Ryan. Australia. That's easy meets, that's easy pickings for Takahiro Tomiyasu. Endo. Plays a 1-2, inadvertently off of Abdul Rahman Al-Jassib. Well, there's your two substitutions, Gabo Shibaski. Replacing the man that was on yellow card, Hinamasa Morita. And the little left back is also making his way out of match, going off, and Nakayama coming off. Changes changes coming now. Shibasaki into the action. Just gets a 1-2. Such a gamble now for Hajime Moriyasu. He hopes now that these last two changes will make a difference. Asano. Good save by Ryan. Turned into the back post. Who's got the final touch? Is it the man from Celtic, Kyogo Furuhashi? But it's 2-1 nevertheless. Ryan, big hand, upwards and over. Substitute Takada Asano is taking the plaudits. Hajime Moriyasu wants his side to concentrate. But I'll have to see that one again. Yoshida with the long ball over the top. Brought down beautifully. He's allowed to go on his left foot. He drills a shot in. And I think that's either come off of Aziz Behic. Little deflection on the shot. And it's Behic with an own goal. Asano's shot. Little bit of a deflection and then a palm away off the inside of the post. And then it's Aziz Behic who puts it into the back of the net. He's certainly not going to make it a night to remember either. Australia have it all to do in the final three and a bit minutes. Mabil. Duke. Isolated somewhat out there. Jago. Kingsbury through to Irvine. Read the run of Boyle there. Easily picked up by Takehiro Tomiyasu. Takada Asano eating every second he can towards that final 90. Aziz Behic is the man that's going to be given the own goal. A little bit of a torrid afternoon, made the mistake for the first goal for Japan. Came across and both times little deflections on the ball have made it difficult for the Australian left back. 8 minutes were gone when a cross came in from Minamino, flicked off the toe of Irvine. Behic missed his kick and Ayo Tanaka fired it in low across the face of goal on 8 minutes. He was already outpaced by Junior Ito earlier on. And now he's just found himself getting an inadvertent final touch to a shot from Takada Asano. He's put it into the back of the net, the Australian left back. Australia's unbeaten run, their 11 straight wins about to be undone. What a big, big result this will be for Japan. Chris. Economidis is about to come on for Australia. Duke has to keep the ball in play, but not successful in doing it. Boyle comes off to be replaced by Economidis. Karacic also goes off. Be replaced by Grant. Got very little time to affect anything here. Yeah, Tanaka, the furthest man forward, but it's Suter who plays the ball to Trent Sainsbury. And on a balance of play, we always felt Japan carried the bigger threat in tonight's game. Behic will want to try and get things. That's a very, very loose challenge. Sainsbury delivers the ball up towards Duke. He's under the ball and he's gone away. been a very, very entertaining Asian Confederation World Cup qualifier. We're into the 90 of the regulation minutes now. Australia's unbeaten winning run of 11 games is about to come to an end. And their unbeaten start of Group B is about to come to an end as well. We're into time added on now. We'll wait to see what Abdulrahman Al-Jassim adds on. It's going to be a minimum of four to be added on. Suta seems to have disappeared into a striking role for the moment. Here he is, the target. Yoshida with an easy header. Irvine. Suta with the header down, can't find Duke. Back to Wade. It'll be a long 4 minutes here for Japan. Irvine again. Will build the target. He's going to get there. Hiroki Sakai. It's a ball way out. Awuramobile is down, holding his foot. Japan may well get over the line here for three valuable points in Group B. Australia's search for a victory on Japanese soil continues. They have looked, frankly, for large portions of this game, second best. It hasn't been a rip-roaring, thunder-busting performance from Japan, but they've always carried the greater threat over the 90 minutes so far. Sano instrumental in that Behejon goal. Just clears his lines. Biyama just rolls the ball out. Long throw about to come in, Grant. Scored the winner in World Cup qualifier recently. Headed up in the air by Tomiyasu. Suta gets a little bit on it, but it just is to have fouled his man. It's a yellow card for Harry Suta. Looks as though it could have been there for the leading of the elbow. I didn't think there was too much in that myself, but who am I to say? Takahiro Tomiyasu gets himself up, Graham Arnold. Not a man I want to tangle with if I've not put my full 90 minutes in. Looks as though he would tell you if not really put your best yards in for the game. That man has in your picture, Matt Ryan. Several saves. Well, it was one apiece. Sano wins the header. Grant heads it forward. Free kick given away in the middle of the park. No matter where you are in the world, where your affinity or emotions lie now, these last few seconds in any game, whether it be in your local park or whether it be on the international stage like this, are always very delicate. This side, goal scorer Hrustic tries to get past his man. Furuhashi blocks it. Asano will get the ball back inadvertently. James Jago's won it well. Duke comes in. And Suta has collided with a Japanese defender. Japan are going to celebrate this as though they've just lifted the cup themselves. This means so much to them. I'm not saying it doesn't mean much to Australia, but their need going into today's game was so much greater. And in fact, Abdulrahman Al-Jassim blows the whistle on a Japanese victory, which has ebbed and flowed in fairness here inside the Saitama Stadium. An own goal from Adam Behej on 85, sealing the deal. Japan comfortably the better side from the 8th minute. Indeed, before that, when Ayo Tanaka got a cross that came in He controlled it after the man in the picture, Adam Behic, had missed his kick, trying to clear. And he rifled it low past Ryan for 1-0. Japan comfortably the better side. Very sedentary pace set by Australia when in possession of the football throughout the rest of the half. But on 41 minutes, Taggart rifled the ball off of the goalkeeper. Just his outstretched arm off Shuichi Gonda hit the post. Australia was still there. They had a puncher's chance, and that punch came on 70 minutes when we thought it was going to be a penalty for Australia. But the free kick was given no more than 150 millimetres outside the penalty area of Japan. And Ajdin Purustic crashed a lovely free kick in, left-footed off the underside of the bar to make it 1-1. And suddenly we had a tense and nervy 20 minutes. But on 85 minutes, substitute Takano Asano fired a shot in. Ryan palmed it up and more towards his back post. It clipped the back post. And in the tangle with Furuhashi, as is Behic, put it into the back of the net. It's no more than Japan deserved. Australia will be disappointed. Graham Arnold there with Hrustic, the goal scorer. He won't be too happy with his team's performance. But they never get anything on Japanese soil, he'll say. They'll pick their heads up, dust themselves off and go again. But for Japan, it's a massive, massive 3 points in a derby which has got the two teams 4,000 miles apart. Here at the Saitama Stadium, I've been Andrew Self. I hope you've enjoyed today's commentary. Japan the victors.